kindly do not ask for very easy solutions. For the simple reason that if there are easy solutions and they come to you, you won't take them. Discomfort is there because you can accept something only when it comes to you with an acceptable level of discomfort. Let's say the whole discomfort is removed and the thing becomes ridiculously easy. Would you take it? Honestly. Would you take it? If it is ridiculously easy, served like this, you won't take it. Tomorrow morning when I'll come to you to wake you up, I'll wake you up and say, take this pill. What is this? This is all the enlightenment pill. You will say, ah, and go back to sleep. Mm-hmm. You will know I'm joking. I might not be joking. Kabir has said that whosoever got it after a lot of tears, hasa has kant na paiya jin paiya tin roye, hasat khelat hari mile to kaun duhagan hoy. It is not that the truth says that you must pass through suffering before I can come to you. It is just that you will not take anything without suffering. If you go to the market, small example, and you visit a shop and you ask, hello, this one, and he says, take it for free. Look at your first reaction. Would you feel happy?
No.
Would you? Immediately a suspicion would come to you, there is something fishy.
Yes.
And then you say, all right, let me see. And then you point to another good and say, this one, that too, take it for free. Now you are sure. You are being trapped. Something is fishy. And then you say, that one, and he says, don't bother me again and again. This whole shop, take it for free. Now you will run away with your dear life. Without looking back, you will run away. And maybe you will inform the police. Right? If it is free, you won't take it. That is why you must suffer and pay the price of the ego, so that you can take it. So the discomfort is auspicious. You will keep feeling discomfort as long as you are not prepared to take things for free. When you are prepared to take it easily, freely, then the discomfort won't be there. Goods are expensive only because you want to pay. When you don't want to pay, have you seen what happens to the price of goods? It comes down. You want to pay because you want to uphold your ego. See, I can't pay any price because I'm a beggar. You'll have to confess that you are a beggar. And when you confess that you are a beggar, he gives it for free. Till the time you keep saying, I have a lot, he says, all right, then give it. You are the one who is claiming that you are so rich, you have so much knowledge, resources, wealth, relationships. You keep telling him, I have so much, I have so much. He says, all right, if you have so much, then kindly give. Go to him and say, I have nothing. He says, all right, the whole shop is yours, take it away. And if you can't take it away, I'll deliver it at your home for free. You say, I don't even have a home. Okay, I'll deliver a home as well.
It's a story, I don't know, it's in Sufism or in Zen, when someone asks the master, who are you? And he answered, I am a dead cat. Of course, he's priceless. So who will take the death time?
Yes.
That's love. Yes. A good metaphor.
You know, that which comes for free, that demands everything. You have to give everything away to get that which is free. One must learn to enjoy paradoxes. Huh?